Hi guys, it's Natalie here. Today I wanted to show you how to make some mixed media Christmas style cards, and I'm making three cards today because this technique is something that sort of lends itself to sort of making cards in bulk. And I wanted to show you some real life examples today because here you're going to see the learning process that I went through and some of the not mistakes, because I don't think there are mistakes when it comes to creativity and art, but some of the things that I learnt that didn't quite go according to plan. So on this first attempt, you can see that what I'm aiming to do is to mix up some colours and to spread them through the stencil onto the background piece of my card. On this first attempt, the base that I'm using is gesso. I chose the gesso because it's got a lovely white background, like it's white, so I thought the colours would work really better to be mixing some nice bright colours. But as it turned out, when I mixed and I used some re-inkers there for the colours, they actually turned out really quite nice and pale and pastel colours, and that was fine. But not quite the bright colour I was after for sort of this galaxy type of look. And I wanted to add a shimmer to it, so you could see that right at the beginning I attempted to add some perfect pearls to that top green colour and mix it in straight into the colour, but it actually turned the gesso quite sort of clumpy and grainy, and you couldn't see the shine at all. So I stopped doing that, and that was one of the lessons I learned. So on the second attempt, I decided to go with a different base medium, and this time I'm using a texture paste. The texture paste that I've got is really quite thick, and you can see how thick that is compared to the gesso that I used the first time around. And this lent itself way better to the idea of sort of scraping it through this stencil, and especially because this stencil that I'm using, which is the radiating star stencil, has a lot of fine details in it and fine lines. And the colors mixed much more boldly, even though I used the same sort of concentration of colour that I did the first time around. You can see the brightness and the boldness of this attempt as opposed to the first one. So that was interesting, and I do like the way that this turned out. And you could see that this worked quite differently from the first go, and I had a bit of the stuff left over, the colours left over, so I thought we'd go for a third card at the same time, and that's what I meant by this technique can lend itself to making cards in bulk, because once you sort of mix up that colour, assuming that you've used enough in the first place, you can go ahead and sort of just do one card after the other. You can see that I never sort of mixed my colours really thoroughly into that texture paste, and I was okay with that idea because I was wanting to go for this sort of galaxy type of look with, you know, the swirling sorts of colours. And so even having some of that white colour come through, I thought still worked really well. So now, as I said, I wanted to add that shine or that glimmer, so I'm using the perfect pearls. And on the day that I made these cards, it was really quite warm outside. It was really, it was really quite hot. And so that texture paste that I used, because it was quite thick, was almost immediately sort of dry. And to add the perfect pearls, you don't want it dry, but you do want it sort of tacky dry. And so I was able to sort of do this straight away, so that was in real time. I just literally stenciled it through and then added the perfect pearls straight away, using a soft brush just to apply it. But when it came to my gesso card, because it was a lot thinner, it was still really quite tacky. It really wasn't dry enough yet, and so you can see that when I added the perfect pearls, when it sort of touched the gesso, I wasn't then really able to spread it very well, and so that made this shimmer quite sort of patchy, which wasn't quite the look I was after. But you know, with these things I always sort of, you know, go with it, learn from it, decide later on if I really like it or don't like it. And ultimately I did still turn that one into a background of a card as well, but it certainly had quite a different look to it than these other two, which were quite sort of similar. And I guess I was much more happy with these backgrounds that I was making as opposed to the first one with the gesso. But you know, you live and learn, and I would know for next time now what I would sort of do and not do. And I'm hoping, of course, by showing you these things that maybe you can then decide which way you'd prefer to go. Now, because I really wanted those backgrounds to be the real sort of star of the card, I didn't want to add too much over the top of them. I wanted those backgrounds to be the focus. And so I decided that to finish off my cards, all I would do is sort of add a bit of a banner sentiment. So I'm using the banners out of the Classic Tag 2 die set. And I start off by cutting the banners and then add my stamping to it, as opposed to the other way around. And that's so that I can make sure that I really do center my sentiments on the banner the way that I want it to fit. And so the sentiments that I'm choosing, I'm making three cards, so I'm going to use three different sentiments, and I'd already made one banner ahead of time. The sentiments that I am using here have come out of the new release stamp set. So this one that I'm currently doing here, Joy to the World, that comes out of the Nativity Play stamp set, and the other one you could see, the Glory to God in the Highest, that came out of the Angel Wings stamp set. Both of those are from the new October release. And after I stamp it, I just want to add that little hole reinforcer. It adds another sort of different color. And so I'm just going to glue those on. And because they're sort of folded over, it just takes a little bit of time when you glue that on to sort of really stick into place. So I'm just holding them in place with that little clip there while they dry. And then to finish off this cards, I'm really keeping it really quite simple. So I'm just trimming it down. These cards have dried properly now. I'm just trimming down those little edges. Then I'm going to mount the banners onto some foam tape so that they stick up a little bit and add a little bit of extra dimension. And then all I'm going to do is, I couldn't decide if I wanted it on a black background or a white background. So I sort of mixed and matched that idea there as well. And I'm going to pop those banners there. And I'm just going to finish off with a sprinkling of sequins, and my random way of sprinkling them is to literally sprinkle them. I drop them from a height, and wherever they land, I'm then going to glue them on in place, and it gives that random look, which is quite nice, I think. And that's it. That's how my card's finished off, and I hope I've inspired you today, and give it a go.